Throughout the series, we're going to be building a project called Plot My Course. It's going to have organizations, team members, authentication, password resets. It's going to have courses inside of those organizations and then modules inside of those courses and lessons inside of the modules. And everything's going to be orderable by drag and drop. So here we have a landing page. It's rendered by AdonisJS. So first off, yes, you can use AdonisJS side by side with InertiaJS, which AdonisJS is AdonisJS's template engine. And all of this is rendered server side. It's just using a simple Tailwind CSS landing page template here. Then we have a register and a login page. So you can either register for a brand new account or log in. And then we also have a password reset flow. If I go ahead and log in here, so fill out my password, I can choose whether or not I want my session to be remembered or not. Go ahead and log in. And we're taken to our courses page. Currently, I only have one course, which is this series. I can see it's currently being planned, its difficulty is medium, and it's a paid course. All three of these settings are unique per organization, but we do have a set of defaults that any brand new organization starts with. I can switch and maintain my organizations by clicking this little dropdown right up here, so I can add in a brand new organization. We'll just call this example. Add that organization, and we can see that this organization doesn't have any courses yet, but we can go ahead and create one. So I'll just fill out the placeholder there, my cool course, select an access level that comes default with this brand new organization, and add that course. We're then taken into this course where we can now add modules. So again, I'll just go with the placeholder there, my cool module, select the status if we wish, and add that module. Now that we have a module, we can add lessons to it. So my cool lesson. A lesson can optionally be given a target publish date. So maybe I want this to be published on Tuesday the 6th. And it can be given an individual access level and a status. Go ahead and add that lesson in there. And we can see our cool lesson, and it's set to be published in one day. We can add in additional lessons. So a follow-up lesson, add that. And we can drag and drop those lessons as needed to reorder them. And the lesson numbering will update accordingly. The first module will be given a module number of 1, and then the lessons inside of each module start at 0 and go incrementally from there. So if we add in another module, a second module, just like so, this module's lessons will now be 2.0, 2.1, 2.3, so on and so forth. So here's a module 2 lesson. We can add that in, and you can see there it is at 2.0. Additionally, if we decide that we want a lesson from module 1 to be in module 2, we can drag it from module 1 over to module 2, and its lesson number will update accordingly. Any of these colored tags that you see here, so like the status, difficulty, access, at either the course, module, or lesson level can be clicked on and changed as needed on the fly. Inside of a course, we also have the ability to edit its details as well as delete it outright. So if we no longer want this course to exist, we can delete it, and there it goes. As mentioned, on a per organization level, we have the ability to customize the difficulties, the statuses, and the access levels. We can reorder these to change what the default option would be. And of course, we can edit and delete them as well. And now if we were to go create a new course, you can see that for our access level, we now only have paid. But if we were to jump back over to our original organization of Adacasts, add in a new course, for our access levels, we now have free and paid because this organization still has both of those. There's also a whole settings panel to this as well. So we have profile settings, which allows the user to customize their name, account settings, which allows them to update their email address, which to do so, they need to confirm their password, just as an additional security step. On top of that, we're also going to track the user's past email history in case there's any discrepancies down the road. We'll have a log to be able to look back to confirm whether or not they have previously used an email that they're trying to get back to. And of course, they can delete their account as well. On the organization level, they can update the organization's name, delete the organization, and invite new members and manage their members as well. So if we were to invite a new member, say maybe contact@adacasts.com, we enter the email in there, we can select their designated role so they can either be an admin or a member. We'll leave them at member and send that invitation out. You can see that we got a toast right down here, so we will also have a toast manager. We can cancel that invitation, and we can see that this user is now in the pending organization invitations, meaning that the invitation has been sent out, they just haven't accepted it yet. We'll be using Mailtrap as our testing SMTP server, so we can head on over to Mailtrap here. Let me jump into my inbox right there, and there is our organization invitation for contact@adacasts.com. I'm going to go ahead and copy this invitation, copy the link for it. Since I'm logged in this browser tab, I'm going to open up a brand new private window, and I'll paste this invitation in, and go. Since this user doesn't have an account, we're taken to the register page. So I can insert a name of Adacast contact, contact@adacast.com, and give them some password. Go ahead and register this user. And there we go. We've now accepted the invitation, and we now have access to the Adacast organization. Furthermore, we don't have the option to edit or delete this organization like we do in our administrator account. So if I hop back over to this, you can see that we have edit and delete here. And we also have organization settings, which we're also taking a look at right here. If I refresh this page, we'll be able to actually see that Adacast Contact is now an organization member, and they've moved out of the pending invitations. If we jump back over to that Adacast Contact account in our private browser tab, click on our little avatar here, we can see that we don't have organization settings. And if we were to dive into our settings panel, organization settings isn't here either. So we do have some level of authorization checking going on at the organization level. However, any member is able to adjust the difficulties, statuses, access levels, create new courses, and edit and maintain courses as needed. So it is a rather feature complete application, as you can tell. We're going to start out with just the basics of InertiaJS and getting comfortable with how that works. And then we'll move into the more feature complete components of our application. And we're going to go through them in the same order that I would whenever we actually build out this application so that you get a flow of how things work.